I'm going to talk about the solver that's available to you in Excel. On the data tab, you go at the end here and it's the solver. So what I've got here is I have a basic mark breakdown. So we have the three marks that make up the final marks for the student. He's already achieved only 75% on his assignments, and he has yet to write his midterm and his final, but he needs to get 90% to get honors in this course. So what he's going to do, we're going to do, is we're going to figure out what he needs to do to get this. We are going to go click the solver button here. And so we've already selected the total that the end calculation here. And so what we have now, we would like to change this value to a value, it gives you to maximum, to minimum, or to a value of. So I'm going to select to a value of, and I want 90. Okay, now the next is, it's asking you by changing which variables. So we click on the red arrow here, and we select the midterm and the final mark here. And now we click the red arrow again. Okay, now we need to add some constraints here. The highest possible mark that he could get on either of these is 100%. So let's add some constraints here. And so what we're going to do is we're going to select the value, or the cell where the value goes. And as you can see, it's less than or equal to. Now, you have, from the drop-down list, you have other options there of what it can possibly be. But this is what we need. So the most it could possibly be is 100. And then we're going to click Add to add it to constraints. And then we're going to click the other cell here, the final. And the same thing, the most it could possibly be is 100. Okay, and so now we say OK. And there it's all ready for you. So now let's click on the solve button here. So let's drag this away. So for this student to get 90 on his final, as a final mark, he needs to get 91 and 100. They put the final value to the highest because the final is worth 40%, so it's more important for him to get the higher mark on the final. And 91.6 is all he needs in the midterm. So we have options here with the dialog buttons. You can keep the solve solution, restore the original values. Okay, so we're going to keep this, but now what we would like to do is we would like to run a report. So let's select answers and say OK. And now we have our answer report here. And as you can see, it has broken down all the information that is determined for you. So this is how you use the solver. By the way, the solver is an add-on. If you don't have this add-on, what you need to go is File on the menu bar, and then you go to Options. And then you go to add-ons, and then you can, as you can see, it's right down here. You just click on that to add it into your options. So that's how you use the solver in the Excel sheet. Please subscribe.